It was a big day here at Davenport Field. Not only were the Hoos trying to secure the series win against Miami, but they also recognized four of their graduating seniors before the game on Mother's Day. I was able to talk to Robbie Coman after last night's win. You missed most of last season with an injury. What did you do over the past year to go from recovering to that to hitting your best this season?
Really just took some time. I think I had surgery, and it was a good 3 months before I could really do anything physical. And so taking that time to focus on some other things, but then refocus back to baseball, I think, you know, it was a good time off. And then, you know, like I said, getting back to it, I, you know, worked out every day with the trainer, doing all the rehab stuff necessary to get me back to be able to play. And then, you know, just having fun my last year. I mean, luckily I'm having success, but hopefully we'll keep it going.
Since injury, you've been seen as by your teammates as like the voice of the team. What's it been like stepping up into that role last season and then carrying it over into this season?
Well, like I said, last season gave me some perspective. You know, really, you go from being on the field every day, pretty much my second and third year, to then being in the dugout every day. And you gotta, you know, there's young guys in there helping them out any way that you can. You know, being that, you know, voice in the dugout, I think really helped me, you know, become a better leader and help those guys now that I'm even back on the field, still taking the time with the young guys to work with them and make sure they're getting the system and understanding everything.
What's some of the best advice you've given so far this year or last year?
More probably personal advice, I would say, is the best advice. I mean, first year you get here and it hits you hard. You got class every day. It's, you know, baseball for a long time. It's, you know, back-to-back. Your schedule's packed. Time management is a big one. I know I struggled with that my first fall. And so really just stuff, little things like that to help them, you know, manage their time better and be able to play and, you know, have success on the field and off the field. I think those are more the life lessons that you learn in this program, and those are the more important ones.
You're getting your master's degree next weekend. Congratulations.
Yeah.
What will you miss the most about this program?
I mean, the people make the place. That's always how I viewed it, and it's held true my 5 years here. I think, you know, no matter if it's classmates or coaches, teachers, you know, teammates, they make this place the best, and that's who I'm going to miss the most for sure, is going to be the people.
I read you had your first college home run against Richmond. Can we expect to see that again on Tuesday?
Oh, man. Maybe. I mean, we'll see what happens, but hopefully we can take care of business on Tuesday. That would be a pretty cool accomplishment to win all the midweek games this year, so hopefully we'll take care of business.
Looking forward to it. Thank you. After losing the first game in the doubleheader on Saturday, a big sixth inning in Game 2 by the Cavaliers lifted them from a close 8-6 game to a definite win. Cameron Simmons hit the grand slam to secure the win with a score of 13-6. In the tiebreaker on Sunday, after the Canes tied it up 3-3, UVA rallied in the eighth, scoring four runs with impressive hits by Andy Weber and Jake McCarthy. With the win, the Hoos separated themselves from Miami in the Coastal Division standings. Virginia now faces Richmond on Tuesday as they try to go undefeated in their midweek games this season.